Please welcome to the stage Senior Director, Product Evangelist, John Suzuki.
You're here! Yay! Love you too. Who said that? I love you. Thank you. Wow, you guys are here. Does this feel kind of surreal to you? Right? I mean, it's been so long. And you know, I got here last night and getting reacquainted with people and seeing people and hugging people and saying hi to people, and everybody got so tall. It was weird. For the last 2 years, I've been living with my wife, and the only person that I would really see is this short, right? And so I come over here, and it's like the land of the giants. But it's just really, really nice to have you guys here. I hope that when this week is over, you guys are going to see this as being the best kept secret this whole year, because you guys are here. We're not doing ResFest this year, right? We're doing Explore. And so what's going on is that I think you guys are going to have an unbelievably great experience, and here's why. You guys are going to get the most out of it, of anybody here. This is the only session that's happening today, right? So you guys are going to, right? It's really great. You guys are going to learn about Escapia. You're going to learn about all the new things that are going on. You're going to learn about where we've been, where we're going, all these different kinds of things. And tonight, we're going to have a really great vacation rental welcome party, right? And all the senior executives of Expedia Group are going to be there, from Peter Kern all the way down. And then for the next 3 days, we're going to feed you breakfast, lunch, dinner, and we're going to have a really great party. But what's going to happen is that today we're going to talk about Escapia. You're going to learn about what's going on in the world of software. Tomorrow morning, we're going to get together and we're going to have vacation rental day, okay? And we're going to give you updates on what's happening in the vacation rental industry at large. Then, tomorrow afternoon, we're going to launch into Explore 22. So Explore doesn't even start until tomorrow afternoon, which is really, really cool. And so then, what's going to happen is that you're going to be introduced, and this is the first time ever, you're going to be introduced to the mainstream of travel, the rest of travel, airlines, hotels, cruises, car rentals, everything, right? Because this is a travel conference. And so I think it's going to be a really, really cool experience for the first time on doing this. And I'm super, super glad that you're here. You know, as I thought about the journey that we've been on, because here's one more thing, and you're going to hear this a lot. Some of you guys have heard me say in the past that someday vacation rentals are going to hit the mainstream of travel, right? COVID-19 comes along and you became the mainstream of travel. Unbelievable performance and unbelievable opportunities, and you guys, our Escapia customers, performed the best in terms of bookings with Vrbo and online travel agents. And so you're going to hear more about this as we go. So hopefully you guys have seen some really great success with Vrbo and the broader picture outside of your software. But I've been around, I started my career here with Escapia 18 years ago. And I kind of thought to myself, gee, wouldn't it be interesting to just kind of look back? And so I put a list of things together for you guys. 18 years ago, there was no web-based software. Okay, 18 years ago, there were no high-resolution photos, no credit cards, no integrated websites, no online bookings, no guest reviews. A lot of these things we at Escapia introduced to the industry. There were no high-speed internet, no keyless locking systems, no mobile computing. This device, the iPhone, was introduced 18 years ago. Okay, no yield management, no market maker. No OTAs, no e-commerce marketplaces for vacation rentals, no price consistency, no amenity searches or optimization, no virtual tours, no distribution optimization. We have come on a really, really long journey, and that doesn't include the thousands of additional features and capabilities that the Escapia team have built over the years. And so with that, I want to bring up Ryan. Ryan Hutchings, General Manager of Escapia. He's going to come join me on stage. We got these. We We got to stand in these little boxes so you can see us up on the screen, and
it's really very structured.
I mean, we're really good friends, but this is pretty close, Ryan.
This is close.
I'll do it.
You stay in your box.
You see, you can see us up there. That's pretty cool. Yeah. So, did all this work? The last time we got together was in 2019, and COVID came along.
That's right.
What happened?
And a lot happened.
Why did you do that?
We thought we were bored, and you were bored. It's good to see all of you. I've seen many faces that I haven't seen in a long time, and I'm sure it feels the same way where we can finally get together. It's good to see everybody pushed up front a little bit. I know BJ tried his best. If you can't tell, he runs usher duties at his church, so you did a good job, BJ, at reminding everyone where they need to sit. It's good to be here. This COVID happened. It's been years since we've been able to do this. We've been itching to get back together. I think we all learned a bunch of things when this happened, right? If you go all the way back when it first hit and you were dealing with the mass cancellations and moving reservations and what to do with the money and refunds and what do we do? Is this going to last all summer or all year? And we paused everything we were doing at Escapia, right? And we actually said, how do we get you what you need right now? Because we wanted to pause too, so we had all these, I remember sending out reports and new booking and cancellation, options for you. But we all kind of went through that. I think one of the things, and I was just talking to Sean earlier today, right before this, was I think one thing that I learned here at Escapia and then also talking to you was at this point, I can't imagine anything that we can't handle and adjust to in a changing environment, right? Like I don't want to say that. I'm sure it can be different and worse, but I think at this point we're so good at adjusting to massive change in a short amount of time. And we're all hopefully used to that. And so that actually is exciting for me to know that I don't have a fear of something big happening and having to pivot because I feel like that's just gonna happen.
Yeah, you know? Yeah. I learned three things. I learned three things during COVID. Okay. The first thing that I learned, which is probably the most important thing, I learned how to color my hair.
It looks good.
It all turned gray. L'Oreal for men. Gents, L'Oreal for men. It's amazing.
You got the back.
I got the back this time.
That's good.
Yeah, I'm not dark in front and black in back. Number two, you guys absolutely kicked butt.
You did.
You guys, was amazing. You guys raised the bar of professionalism way high. Like I said, and that was part of the deal that you guys didn't know. In order for you guys to become the mainstream of travel, you guys had to perform. And you guys did. It was amazing. And all of us at Vrbo and Expedia Group were just amazed at how well everybody did. And look at the industry now, right? It's just amazing. And the other amazing thing, the third thing I learned was what Ryan just said, how Escapia responded. Because every one of us, you, me, Ryan, the whole Escapia team, the whole industry had to respond. We had no choice. And we all learned things about ourselves that we never knew, right?
That's right.
And so it was just an amazing experience. And one of us is supposed to have the thing, and that's me.
That was you.
I'm supposed to have this, and I'm just messing
right,
up completely. So this was my welcome back slide. This was from 3 years ago. I was supposed to show this to you, I don't know, about a minute and a half ago. And this is Ryan Hutchings.
Here.
Yeah,
welcome.
You're here. You've
okay.
been. You've
Thank
been
you.
Here. So you saw Ryan. So, and this is me, guys. You guys know this. And whew, what a
here
ride.
We are. What a ride.
Right?
Yes. So we do have a lot. And I remember when we talk about the ride and the last time we were together, right, in 2019, ResFest, for those of you that were there, we talked a lot about change. And we kind of kicked off this whole let's do a lot of change thing before it became popular with COVID. But we announced a lot at that ResFest. And John was on stage. I was here. Y'all that were there. And we talked about our plans and our vision for the future. We said, hey, we need to get everything onto one brand, one platform. We're going to consolidate all of our softwares into one, Escapia. And then by doing so, we kind of were looking into the future and said, if we can do this, we think we can deliver more to you. We can do it faster and better because we won't have, split emphasis on a bunch of different programs and platforms. So that was the promise. So we talked about these three things. And so John was there and we launched things on stage live and we said, here's what we envision for the future. So right now I want to go back a little bit and talk about what happened since then, because y'all have been busy, we've been busy, but I want to recap a little bit on here's what we said we would probably do and what we wanted to do, and then where did we actually end up? So with that, I'm gonna go
into it. And before you do that real quick, because I'm gonna exit stage left, one of the things that we also talked about at the last Res Fest is not only did we want to get you more bookings, but we want to make you better bookings.
That's right.
Right? Some of you guys might remember that. And so the whole idea is building these different kinds of programs and the tools to take advantage of these programs that not only get you more bookings, but better bookings to help you do better business and have more fun, right? And so with that, I'm out.
You'll be back
Ryan,
in a minute, but
I'll
we're
be back.
Talk more
I'll
about
be back.
This. Thank you,
Thanks.
John. But we're gonna talk more about that. Hopefully you've seen the more bookings. I'm gonna get into that in a minute because we track it closely too on your behalf. We wanna know what's going on. And so fortunately, as Escapia, we can see all of it, right? But when we went back to ResFest, we promised a few things. They said, if we can do what we say we're gonna do, you should get more support, you should get more innovation, and then all of that combined should give you a little bit more efficiency with you and your teams, especially your staff, and we know that's important. So let's talk about the support side. When we announced in 2019, we said we should be able to get all of our support teams, those that were supporting V12 and Escapia and all the different parts of our organization, into one area. And so we did that. We combined support teams, cross-trained everybody. And I'm happy to say that on the support side, our goal is always, hopefully you don't have to reach out very often because that means the software is working, but we also know it's just going to happen. Right? That's just the nature of us running our business and you running yours. So when you do reach out, we want you to talk to a person. Our goal has never been to completely offload support so you don't have to have a person on the other end of the phone. That's important. We all love the relationship-based part of this business, and we value that with you. And so our support team, since 2019, we did invest. We doubled our support team behind the scenes at Escapia. We doubled it. Right? Before, we were supporting it, and we realized the growth is going to come here, so we invested. We doubled the support team. That allowed us to answer more of your questions in a more efficient way, and we have a different group now than we had before supporting you differently. Because we doubled it, we did find that now we're seeing record response times. More than 90% of the time when you reach out to support directly, we answer faster than we ever have in the history of HomeAway Software / Escapia. So I'm hoping you feel that. That deserves it. I hope you do feel. I hope when you pick up the phone, you get somebody, right? Does that mean every ticket is answered in record time? No, but we have different teams now that work on different complex issues for you. Also, because of that, we do see that 40% of the time, now we've seen a 40% increase in our team being able to support you and their efficiency. And so that is all aimed at helping you move faster and get the answers you need so you don't have to wait. So number one, we felt like support has gone really well. Plus all the increased hours, right? We do evenings and weekends. Our staff in Australia covers hours that we never could have before. So hopefully all those things make sure that you have available support. Next is the innovation. We have new features that we've come out with. We're going to create the next generation of property management software, and no one's better poised to do it than us with the support that we have. On stage, we launched, and at ResFest, we launched, if you remember, the performance dashboard that you have in Escapia. We launched that live on stage at ResFest. We showed it to you, and we said, hey, by the way, open up Escapia. You can use it right now. And we had opportunities coming in where you could accept rate recommendations, if you remember. People started doing that live at ResFest, and we could see the numbers coming through and report it out. That was exciting. Hopefully, you're utilizing some of this new technology. I can tell you right now, as I talk to some of you and have phone calls, because I do talk to a lot of customers on a regular basis, that performance dashboard, I had a couple of property managers tell me it makes them look like a hero to their owners if you're utilizing it the right way. They're saying, it's amazing to have an owner call in and me to pull up the performance dash and say, here's what you're doing year over year, here's what it's projected, here's where you're at today, without having to export reports and manually calculate some stuff in Excel and send them something after the fact, right? So hopefully you're utilizing this to grow your portfolio. And then we also have new modules. We're gonna talk a lot about the new things here shortly, so I won't get into that. We're also gonna talk about this third bullet point. This is important, you don't see it a lot, and it's something behind the scenes, but we spend a lot of time doing it, security and compliance. Expedia Group is held to a different standard than a lot of these other software companies or private groups because we're a publicly traded company. And as such, we have to meet very stringent requirements there. We go along with that at Escapia. So we follow that same high bar of standard for security and compliance. That includes all the traveler data that you're regularly using, all the processed payment transactions. Everything that's in Escapia is housed in ultra-safe lockboxes virtually. And we do that because we think it's important. And there's more to come, and we're going to get into. What I want to do right now is talk about how this efficiency will actually help you move forward, right? So part of the efficiency, if we look at that final promise that we made, was are there things that we can help you and your staff do better and faster that they don't have to spend a lot of time on? And we know that those complaints come back to you, right? If your front desk is like, this is taking forever, you'll hear that about 30 times a day, 7 days a week, and then eventually we hear about it, right? We don't want that to happen. And so what we want to do is have everything be way more efficient than it was. So you asked for a couple things. You asked for automation and email sending, right? When a reservation comes through, you want guests to automatically receive reservation confirmation emails. So we launched that, and hopefully you're using that. You also wanted some more choice in some areas. For a long time, we've only had one payment processor option. We worked really hard, and now you have three options to choose from. If you didn't know, talk to us, and we'll talk to you about what those options are. It adds payment processors that you can explore, also adds gateway connections if you want to use your own. So we opened that up for you. Hopefully you're taking advantage of that. Also, you wanted upload capabilities for photos on your service orders, mobile. We know as your teams are out in the field and service orders comes in, having pictures is vital to what's happening, and that can be uploaded now. And then we're going to talk a little bit more about APIs and speed and performance in a little bit. But all of those things are where we focus on bringing you more efficiency. Hopefully, Escapia, you've noticed, it's always been very reliable. But hopefully, you've noticed that it doesn't take a long time to do some tasks now. It performs faster. You shouldn't have to be waiting. And we spent a lot of time looking at all the areas of Escapia and what takes the longest and making it quicker, processing speed. So as such, that was the 2019 ResFest promise, right? It's like, hey, we think we can do this if we go this route. And we feel like we've done a pretty good job at going that path. We've seen a lot of what you've seen, which is the ups and downs of what's happening just in the nation and staffing and everything, and we try to weather that just like you do, but we feel like we're on the right track there. As such, I'd say the theme today is, okay, that's what we did, so how are we moving forward now together? The moving forward part comes from us doing it hand in hand, and that's our theme right now. Today, we're gonna have one theme, which is together. We're better together, and I think we really are. So there's three parts to this I'm gonna talk about right now. One is, how are we better together? Number two, how we build this together. When I say together, I mean you as a property manager, us at Escapia, and also us as Expedia Group. I'm gonna talk about what that means a little bit and how the benefit comes down to you being part of Expedia Group. And then, how are we moving forward into the future and what that looks like? So if we get really specific now, building better together, I'm gonna first put a shout out for those in the room, and I know there's a handful that were on V12, and you made the difficult time and effort and the task to move over to Escapia. So welcome to the family in general of Escapia. It was a lot of work, but welcome. This is when we all benefit together. You're bringing insights, but we know it was a lot of work. So I wanna say that first and foremost. So how does this togetherness work? Well, when you have this combination of Vrbo, Escapia, and Expedia Group, what you get is a few benefits that nobody else gets in the industry. You only get these things because you're an Escapia customer. This is a question I get a lot of times. When I'm out, you know, at the conferences with you all, or when I talk to you in the hallway, a lot of the first questions I get from each of you is, hey, I'm on Escapia, I list on Vrbo, I kind of want to list on Expedia maybe, but I do all the things that your company is doing. Is there something that I'm getting out of doing all this stuff that you asked me to do? And the answer is yes. And some of that is going to go over here, but we put it into four categories because, again, we track this very closely on your behalf because I want to make sure you are getting benefit, right? First is, we talked a little bit about, but the support. It's a different kind of support. It's not just the support when you pick up the phone and dial into Escapia. We're talking about what happens after the fact. Our teams plus the Vrbo teams work closer now than we ever have before. You know, before you would say, hey, I could call in, but there's a listing side issue, that's a different team. Or there's an issue with Escapia, but I gotta talk to somebody else and submit a separate ticket, and then you might hear back from one team, but not, there was a lot. And that still technically happens, but we realize that your experience is better if you can just talk to us being the same company, and I've heard that. And so we do. We work a lot behind the scenes for you. Our teams talk to each other with the listing side, with the partner success and optimization side that you can go down and take advantage of. We talk to each other a lot behind the scenes on your behalf because we want you to have minimal points of contact. And so we're doing that. And the handoffs go very, very smoothly now when we're trying to resolve those issues. And not only do we work better together, but like I mentioned, we're twice as large as we were. The Vrbo team's as large, so you look at this as an extension of support. So you have the largest support team as an Escapia customer than every other software out there could possibly have because of the combination of what we're providing for you. And again, that's a single point of contact through us at Escapia. And I hope you realize that that's our goal, is to always have one point of contact, lots of support. Secondly, is how we build our products better. We have 100% dedicated resources or team members that are always just Escapia. We only work on Escapia. That's our whole goal. We run this business as a standalone business within Expedia Group. And I've talked about that with many of you. However, we also leverage Expedia Group technology. We'll get into that in a little bit with some of the demos, but our tech teams, our engineers, our developers, our product managers that you'll talk to here in a little bit, they are part of broader Expedia Group teams that support Escapia and want to see us succeed. And therefore, they share with us. They share code bases. They share technology. They say, hey, I think you might want this. And our teams work really closely with them and say, I think I can bring that into Escapia. Right? So we have other teams developing code and features that we don't have to develop, that we can grab and put into Escapia and say, I think you might value this. Let's see if it works. And that allows us to move faster. So that allows us to do more with the technology that we share as a group. Then we also have access to data. We've talked about this for years. Hopefully you've seen, if you're on the new rate editor or the previous one, the new rate editor especially has rate recommendations. Those are being powered by Expedia Group data. Okay, the old market maker, we call it market rates now, like that is still happening. And that is Expedia Group recommending rates based off of a lot of algorithms. So it's happening. And that's Expedia Group benefit. And then finally, what I mentioned before, that security and compliance. We are PCI compliant as Escapia individually, but also we roll into the broader group of security and compliance that Expedia is held to as a standard. That means your data is secure, always will be. And we hope that you value the security there. I can't imagine anything more scary than thinking your traveler's data, payment data, customer data is at risk because it's held in a small group, privately owned somewhere in a server or somebody's computer that may or may not get breached, right? That's a big deal. That's a lot of traveler data and a lot of information that's private that could be in a lot of trouble for everybody. So we take it seriously. That's how we build a better product with Expedia and us together. And finally, these last two, we hope that because of those two things, you get a better experience. Our connection to Vrbo, the listing side of the business, is the strongest of any software provider out there. And that means the strongest as in we work closely with the team, our connection status is secured, and it performs really well. We have provided this distribution channel for free, meaning that we don't charge you for the distribution portion of it, and that will always be free. Every other solution out there will charge you for distribution, even to Vrbo, in one way or another, whether they capture it with percentage-based charges, flat rate distribution fees per unit. You kind of know how it all works, but Vrbo here will always be free for us and for you. And we want to make sure that's always the case because we want to encourage you to utilize Vrbo as much as possible. And because of that, our connection to the Vrbo side of the business is the status that we have, as you see here, is called elite status. I'm happy that 2022, we're an elite status connectivity partner to the Vrbo group. We're evaluated, Escapia. We're evaluated as a third party, just like every other software provider out there is. And we have to meet standards to receive this status. We've been elite partners ever since this program was started every year for at least 8 to 10 years. And there's only 10% of software providers out there that can ever reach this status. And that means you're doing things like less booking errors caused between our system and theirs. You get more bookings, it performs, it responds, it does all the things you need it to do in a timely fashion to reach this level of status. So we're happy that we can provide that because we know you'll perform better. Speaking of performing better, that means because of all these reasons, we see here that the performance that you get, and this is the biggest takeaway, if you get nothing else today, I want to reemphasize, as an Escapia customer, we see on average that you perform twice as well as other listings do in the marketplace coming from other software solution integrations. That means because you're on Escapia, we see that your listings perform better. So why is that? Why would your listing perform better because you're using Escapia? Well, it's because we do the things that we know make better listings. We know what's coming out. We talk to the Vrbo teams. We know what's important. We know what travelers are searching for. We make sure we update our APIs. So when you see new amenity options in Escapia, guess where that's coming from? It's coming from the Vrbo team saying, these are going to come out. You better put those in. And we say, well, yeah, we better do that because that means your listings will rise to the top and booker and travelers will want to book that. And so we want to make sure that's always the case. We see double the revenue on average from Escapia listings than from any other source. That means your listing that you have on Vrbo right now performs better because you're an Escapia customer. And this helps not only you, but it helps us too, right? Because then we can see what works and what doesn't, and that's how we make improvements to Escapia. It's a win-win for everybody. So we want you to know that we look at this and we know it's important not only to us, but to you. Of course, we want you to list more. Of course, I want you to do everything that we ask you to do, but we do that because we know it is going to perform the best for you, and we want the best for you. So if we look at that, that's the together part, right? That's how Expedia Group plus Escapia can work together, and that's how behind the scenes what's happening to then boost your performance in both the marketplace and then also your direct bookings, which we know are really important. So it's quicker, it's better, it's stronger, and I want to let you know that we're always aiming to keep going and keep that momentum on your behalf. If you have questions about it, always come to us and say, how is it going? Talk to the partner success, the listing optimization team on the Vrbo side. They know this about Escapia just as much as we do, and they're happy to talk to you about it. So we hope that, A, you see that on your listings, and also you know that what we do in Escapia is all aimed at making sure your listings, whether it's on Vrbo or just on your website, by the way, will be the best option that the travelers see versus these other places that they could choose from. So I want to now switch gears a little bit and say there's the benefit of working together. How does working together in this environment mean a better product for Escapia? So right now I'm going to bring out our director of product management, which is Tony Buyajian. Many of you know Tony. Tony, come on out, and he's going to talk through what's happening in the product. Tony, come on out. All right, take it away, and I'll be back out in a minute.
All right, thanks, Ryan. Hi, everyone. My name is Tony, and I lead the product team for Escapia. We have some really great stuff, including some excellent demos to show you here today. But first, I just want to say how excited I am to be back together with all of you here in Las Vegas. Now, even though it's our first time being together in a couple of years, one thing has never stopped, and that's how we partner with each of you to build Escapia. We understand that you rely on Escapia to run your business, and we take the responsibility that comes with that seriously. Ryan already spoke about how we're modernizing Escapia, and what I want to emphasize is that we're doing that based on your feedback. Let me give you a couple of examples. First, let me talk about how we release new tools for Escapia using our all-new Rates Manager as an example. In the past, our approach would have been to try to anticipate every single feature you're going to need and to build all of those things before giving you access. But we've discovered some limitations to this approach. First, when we're building something like the Rates Manager, many of you don't need every single feature that's part of it to begin using it and benefiting from it. Second, we'll miss things. The very best feedback we get is from people who are using our products. So the more that we can do to put something in your hands early, the better we're going to be because we're going to get that feedback sooner. So to improve on this process, we've made some changes to how we release new features. I like to think about this as baking a cake. The basic requirement for any cake is that it's cooked and that it has frosting. So that's the first thing we're going to do. But we're going to keep going. We're going to add some sprinkles. But you know what? We're fresh out, so we have to go to the store and buy some. Now, sprinkles are great, and many of us love sprinkles, but it may not be worth waiting. Perhaps we'd want to eat sooner and just not have the sprinkles. And then after the sprinkles, again, we're going to keep going. We're going to put cherries on top and that very exciting-looking candle as well. But again, that takes more time. Most of us would probably prefer cherries and to see what that candle's all about. But again, if all you really needed was a basic piece of cake with frosting, it's probably not worth waiting. So bringing this back to our rates manager, we've baked the cake. It has frosting. It has sprinkles on top. It even has cherries. We're going to keep going, and we're going to add that candle. But unless you absolutely need that candle to enjoy your piece of cake, there's no reason to wait. Go ahead and dig in. This enables us to get products into your hands sooner, to begin getting that excellent feedback even earlier in our process. Expect to see us do even more of this with our future releases. So it's not just our release strategy that's changed over the past 2 years. We've also had to change the way that we engage. So even though it's been mostly over video calls since ResFest 2019, across all of our Escapia product delivery teams, we've held a total of 22 focus group sessions, 161 one-on-one feedback meetings, and 21 product usability studies. Through these forums alone, we've learned a lot, and we've made 70 product enhancements based directly on your feedback. Let me give you an example of something that we recently learned from our rates management focus group. One of the things that you told us was that you needed an even easier way to configure discounts or premiums for guests who were staying for longer durations. So based on this feedback, we were able to quickly alter our roadmap, and we have a great new feature we're about to release that I know you're gonna love. You also told us that you wanted better support for third parties to enter rates into Escapia on your behalf. Well, I don't wanna steal any more thunder from the rate session happening right after this, so I'll just say if you're interested in rate management and better pricing, you don't wanna miss that session. If you've already participated in a feedback session or a focus group, thank you for helping to make Escapia a better product. If you haven't participated in one of those yet, we still want your feedback as well. You've probably noticed this little blue submit feedback button that's starting to appear on different pages throughout Escapia. Click it anytime and let us know what you're thinking. This feedback comes straight to the product team, and it's an absolute goldmine of information for us. We look forward to hearing from you. So we're about to jump into product demos, but before I do that, I want to provide a bit more information on Rates Manager. Unlike the things that you're about to see, Rates Manager is already available to everybody here inside of the room today. We know that many of you have already made the switch over to it, and for those of you that haven't, we'd love to help the rest of you move on as well. So please attend the Managing Rates and Escapia breakout session happening right after this for more information on how to get started. And spoiler, it's super easy. And keep providing us with that valuable feedback. Of course, if you have any questions while you're at the show, our support lab is going to be open, and we'd love to hear from you there. All right, so who's ready to see what's next? Who wants to see some product demos and a couple of sneak peeks? All right. That's what I thought. So we know that you need software that does even more for you, and that one of your pain points is around communication. Today, you're jumping between multiple systems to communicate with your travelers, your owners, and your staff. Well, what if we could bring all of that together? Please welcome Wes to the stage. Wes has over a decade of... himself. Wes, come on up.
What's the code?
I don't know where they sit it.
Is it this door?
I don't know.
There's no keypad.
There's no keypad? Is this the right address? I know they sent it to me. I've seen it.
Is it
I just don't know where.
Hurry up, it's cold.
I don't know.
There's a keypad on it.
Maybe they texted it. Or maybe it came from Verbo.
How many of you have received this exact call or seen this on your own Ring cameras? My guess is that it's more common than not. even when you did everything right and sent the check-in instructions. Well, now Escapia can help. Our new communication hub allows you to message your guests from your desktop or mobile device. Here we are in the mobile instance of Escapia. We're going to choose the communication hub inbox, and I can toggle back and forth and open and close the drawer. I can look here at all the messages that have been received, whether it's an inquiry or a booking. I can choose just to look at inquiries, or if I choose to look at booked only, I can do that as well. Today we're going to look at the category of post stays. I'm going to search for a guest named Christopher. I'm going to find that he stayed with us and he checked out on April 15th. I'm going to click into Christopher's conversation and see a little more of the history. Christopher starts out on March 1st with an inquiry on Vrbo and begins to ask some questions. I can see that he's coming with his boys and has a few other concerns. And as I go down further, I can see the property manager responds. I can see the V icon, and we can see that there are several back and forth questions. The V icon means that the host responded from the Vrbo dashboard or by simply responding to the inquiry email. I go down a little bit further, and I can see he asked a question. He asked for a discount, of course, and a few other things. And Daffodil, the property manager, continues to respond to Christopher. Later, on March 3rd, I can see that Christopher decides to go ahead and reserve the property. And I can see now that the inquiry has converted to a Vrbo booking. And as you scroll down, Christopher begins to have several more questions, and Dorothy, at this point, responds. Christopher asks for payment clarification on how to heat the pool and questions about how warm it will be once he pays. And as we continue down, we see lots of conversation back and forth with the manager. We finally see that Christopher asks for check-in details. And he later has a question about the pool heating again. Daffodil responds, but you'll notice this time the V logo does not appear. That means that she responded from directly inside of the Escapia inbox. Next, Christopher sends a picture of a concern he has, and I can see that by clicking on the thumbnail that the pool is only heating to 72 degrees on the thermometer. And obviously, he thought he was paying for a higher temperature. Daffodil says, yes, I'm going to send the property or the pool mechanic out to work on it. And I continue down, and finally, at the end of this conversation, I can see that Christopher is a happy camper. If I want to send Christopher another message, I can type in the dialog box to say, thank you for your stay, and I can send this as a text message if I choose. The ability to text your guests was the number one requested item by the property managers as we begin designing the communications hub. So from now on, as long as there's a valid phone number for the guest, you will be able to send texts, as well as each message will be copied to the Vrbo dashboard or even the Airbnb dashboard in the future. It doesn't matter if that guest is standing at the front door and can't remember where you sent him that message. If he opens his text messages, it will be there. If he opens Vrbo, it will be there. We wanted to create options for both you and the guest. You can send and receive messages on your mobile device or desktop, and the guest can receive texts, emails on the Vrbo dashboard. So now let's take a look at a desktop demo. Here we see an example of a conversation regarding a cancellation. The property manager, Courtney, sends a message from the inbox and also sends it by SMS as notated by the SMS badge next to her conversation bubble. The guest sends a thank you response and ultimately Vrbo confirms that the reservation was canceled. Here is an example of the search functionality where we look for a guest named Haley. And we find her in the post-stay category. We see that Haley asked about streaming, and the property manager, Courtney, responded giving her the streaming capabilities. If the booking was initiated from Vrbo, every response, whether it's an SMS or an email, is also copied to the Vrbo dashboard. On the other hand, every message that is sent from the Vrbo dashboard or by a response to a Vrbo email is copied to the Escapia inbox. You should never lose a message, and the guest should always get the response, regardless of which communication method they were using. Finally, here's a sneak peek of the right-hand drawer, which is currently in development. Think sprinkles. The drawer, once complete, will display reservation details, payment details, guest contract information, the calendar, and even a private note section. You can also see that you have options to send an attachment. Much like the guest sent us the picture of the pool temperature, we can send them check-in instructions, a map of the property, different things like that. You can also create a quick reply to answer those all too often frequently asked questions. Or you can even send a templated email to the guest. One last thing to notice is the unread message count by category, which is designed to help you keep up with messages that have not been addressed. So to wrap things up, you all have told us that while you knew we were working on huge projects like the Communication Hub, it was important that we also release smaller improvements along the way. The number one request that we got from customer feedback while researching the Communication Hub was that you wanted the ability to text guests. Well, guess what? We heard you, and as an attendee of Explore, you will have the option to be one of the very first users of our text messaging functionality. You're getting the cake with the frosting, and the sparkles and the sparklers are coming later. Please come by our booth in the main hall and sign up to have that functionality turned on in the coming weeks after Explore. Start texting your guests for free from inside of Escapia, and if your guest's reservation was from Vrbo, that text message will also be carbon copied from the Vrbo app, or carbon copied into the Vrbo app, so that guest will never again have to remember which tool he or she was using when they got that message about how to check into their vacation home. Back to you, Tony.
All right, thanks, Wes. Wasn't that exciting? Text messaging in Escapia, long-time request. So, quick question for the room. We're gonna do a very scientific poll here, and we're just gonna vote with our hands. So, by a show of hands, how many of you would say that your single greatest passion in life is managing guest rental agreements? Anybody? Okay, I'm not seeing actually any hands go up, but so it seems like there's a great opportunity here for Escapia to make something easier so you don't have to worry about it so much. Our next presenter has about 15 years of experience in the industry, and she's actually been a reservation manager at a successful property management company in the past, and she is now our product expert on rental agreements. She's gonna show you how we're gonna make this process easier than ever before. Please welcome Caitlin.
Thanks, Tony. So I bet he's right, and none of you, I heard that nobody raised their hand, so none of you are passionate about rental agreements. But how many of you send rental agreements to your travelers? Yeah. Did you know that 75% of Escapia users use Glad Contracts as their primary way to send rental agreements? And that in the past 12 months, you have sent nearly 1 million rental agreements through Glad Contracts. Today, to do this, you need to manage two systems, managing your rental agreements through Escapia and Glad Contracts. In the future, we want to change this, making it easier for you to send rental agreements right from Escapia. So let's take a look at the demo and see how this is going to work. In the new rental agreements platform, we have created a dashboard for you to see the status of your rental agreements. You will no longer need to look at each reservation or run a report to find this information. By quickly looking at the demo in the platform, you can see who has signed the rental agreement and who still needs to. You can quickly access the reservation by clicking over here, or you can download a signed or unsigned rental agreement. You can even cancel all from this dashboard. But what if you want to make a change to the rental agreement you're sending out? Working closely with the Communications Hub team, we have created a new template editor that will allow you to set up your rental agreements from inside of Escapia. Here's the new templates editor page that shows all of the templates created. Since currently this only works for rental agreements, this is the only template you see. If I want to make a few edits to my rental agreement, I can click right here to make that happen. Here's the new rental agreements template editor. We want to make it as simple as possible for you to find what you need inside this editor. We've streamlined the merge tags, making it faster by creating clear and intuitive names. We can also set up which unit groups we want to send it to. And you can decide when you want it to send out automatically to the traveler. So I'm going to set this template to send out after the first deposit is fully paid. And now this will automatically send out to the traveler. So the traveler will now be able to sign this rental agreement from their mobile device or their computer. And the signed agreement will flow back into Escapia for you to view the reservation in the reservation or the new rental agreements page. So what I showed you today is just the beginning. You know, that plain but delicious cake. But we still plan to add to it. We are currently working on adding a preview function so you can know what your agreement looks like without setting up that test reservation and trying to test how it goes out. We're setting it so you can set it by category, so you can decide if it goes out to all categories. Maybe you don't want to send it to certain categories. We're creating an addendums function and the way to collect IDs from your travelers. So if you want to start using this new platform today or want to learn more, Tony's going to tell you how to do that at the end of the demo. Thanks.
All right, thanks, Caitlin. So shifting gears from communication a little bit, we want to talk about one other area that you've told us needs improvement, and that's your listing content and your unit information. I know it's no surprise to anybody here inside of this room that traveler search behavior has changed a lot in the past couple of years, as have OTA listing requirements, and it's important that you're able to represent your information accurately. Our next presenter is an expert in these changes, as well as OTA listing requirements, and she is going to show you all how Escapia is making some changes to help you get even more reservations. Please welcome Bridget.
This girl is on fire. This girl is on fire.
Thanks, Tony. So at Escapia, we know that units are the center of your business, and there's a lot of information associated with each unit, from the business aspects to the listing content that shows up on the listing site. And all of this can be a lot to manage. So we want to make it easier for you to define this information to align more closely with the travel industry and have it presented to travelers on listing sites so they can book your property without question. Over the next few quarters, we're going to be releasing pages centered on listing content, with pages like amenities, location details, and property features, all with a refreshed new look. So let's go ahead and take a look at a demo. The new screens will have an updated navigation on the left-hand side of the screen, and the fields and data on the pages will be more readable. The updated header will make it clear which unit you are looking at with more descriptive content. Additionally, we'll be organizing and categorizing the data in a more intuitive way so that you'll be able to see listing content separate from the management data. Now, we know everyone loves a good updated look, but let's get into some of the features that are going to make running your business a little bit easier. First up, we have amenity management. So I'm sure you've looked at the current amenity screens and have had a few questions about what's going on. Things like, where are these amenities going to show up? What even is a standard amenity, or what if I want it to say 62-inch TV instead of just TV? Well, with our new screens, we hope to make the answers to those questions much clearer. We started by getting rid of numerous tabs and long lists that are hard to read and replaced it with clear categories. We also added the ability to filter down to only show the selected amenities so you get a big picture of what your unit has, or maybe what it doesn't have. And this can point out some potentially easy areas to make additions. For example, adding some kitchen amenities to this unit. Knowing where your amenities are going to show up has been a major pain point. So we're making it much more obvious which amenities are considered to be a part of Escapia's core set of standard amenities and which are the custom amenities that you have created by separating them into two different tabs. The amenities on the standard tabs are standard to the travel industry, and these amenities are most likely to map to amenities on distribution sites, which is ultimately dependent on what the site supports, and since not every amenity will show up on every site, we've also added another filter to show you the amenities that will explicitly map to Vrbo. This will allow you to definitively know which will show up on your Vrbo listings and which will not, which is going to eliminate a lot of the confusion that currently exists. So over on the custom tab, you'll be able to create amenities that are specific to your business. The amenities on this tab aren't really going to map to the major travel sites, meaning that this tab is best for defining amenities for your personal websites because you can more granularly define what your units have. So this is where you can create your 62-inch TV inline, and it'll be available for your personal website. Finally, we are adding a cherry on top feature, which will allow you to define your bedroom and bathroom configurations. So no more calls from travelers to see if the room configuration fits their needs, and instead they can book your property with confidence. On initial setup, you'll be able to see your old configuration for reference and then add the various bedrooms and bathrooms with the appropriate features. So in this unit, we've got two bedrooms. So in the first bedroom, we'll click the bedroom type here, add a king bed, and then in the second bedroom, we're also gonna add a double bed here, and have the quantity of two. And then we're gonna add a new bed type for other bed and add the quantity there. You can also add another bedroom from this screen as well. So we're gonna make this a studio bedroom and add a queen bed here. And then when we apply that, it'll bring us back to the main screen so you can see all three of those bedrooms and the beds that are in each of them. You can also go into the bedrooms and edit those. So we'll make this bed, this king bed, a queen, apply, and that'll bring us back to this main page again. So initially, this feature is just going to feed over to your Vrbo listings, but it's going to be available for other distribution sites as well shortly after release. And we're super excited about this feature because it not only helps travelers plan for their trip, but it also aligns with industry standards, and it'll boost your rankings on distribution sites, which means more bookings for you. Now I'm going to pass it back to Tony, who can give you a little bit more information on how to sign up for early access to some of these features.
All right. Thanks, Bridget, and thanks to the entire product team for the excellent demos of upcoming features. As an added bonus for everybody who's in attendance today, we have a special early access opportunity for units, rental agreements, and also for Communication Hub. If you're interested in getting access to these before anybody else and getting that very first slice of cake, go ahead and pull out your phone, open up the camera app, and aim it at that big QR code on either one of the screens. It should then give you a link that you can click on that'll take you to a form. You can put in your name, your company name, and pick which of those products, or maybe all of those products, you want early access to. Now, if you don't have your phone with you or need a bit more time, we are going to have this code at the Escapia booth as well in the main exhibit hall, so you can bring it by at any point during the next couple of days and get registered for those, and we'd love to get you on there and start getting your feedback.